you're telling me that you truly believe in, meaning you have perfect faith and trust in God, the way that you would have to have faith in a parachute should you jump off of an airplane. You go through the Ten Commandments and you see, acknowledging that your very purpose on this planet is to worship this same God.
We have claims that there's an intelligent designer, but we have a natural explanation for virtually everything thus far. Other than we don't know how the Big Bang was initiated, which is true, it is fallacious to then say, because we don't have a better explanation, we are just going to stick with the current explanation, which is God. We have the problem of God sending people to hell, which is eternal damnation for finite sins, which is by definition unjust. We have the problem of God being faith-based, which faith in and of itself is a terrible method of coming to truth, because there is not a single position that you could not take on faith. Faith is the excuse that you give when you don't actually have evidence. You brought up the parachute example, but we have evidence that parachutes work. That's why we trust the parachute. I don't have any evidence that God has actually worked. I have evidence to the contrary, where people have prayed and prayed and prayed, and they've tracked this and studied it, and the people that were prayed for didn't do any better than the people that weren't prayed for. What we have here is natural explanations. We have a God who hasn't made himself detectable in any meaningful way. We have a God who is also going to punish us for not believing in him with eternal damnation if we don't have faith, which is unjustified belief, which some could argue is irrational. So unless I am irrational in my thought process, I cannot then be a Christian.
Yeah, man. I mean, I get that you feel that way, but it does nothing for me to convince you to agree with me beyond me trying to be loving towards you.